that's built, no matter how strong or weak, there is some sort of bond between those two people now.
Yeah.
So, and so if you know that this, you know, there's a possibility, especially if you've experienced it a couple times, you know, it is your responsibility to say, well, I don't want to make this mistake again. I see how these other guys were. Right? That's your responsibility right there. Because you got to look out for you. And no one's going to look out for you how you look out for you.
You're right. But I was, you know, I was young at the time. I was young and dumb. And I wasn't looking out for the signs and all of that stuff. I guess, you know, sometimes you just want to be with somebody.
So this has been a while ago.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. This was a long time ago. And I don't be in...
So that shouldn't be relevant now anymore.
I don't be in short-term relationships. So I don't have a lot of body count, Taza Doc.
No, but you were saying that. You were saying, okay, so let me ask you this. So what's not a lot? What's not a lot?
Hold on, I'm sorry.
What's not a lot?
Hold on, I'm getting over
it. She wants to know how much, what's a lot for you.
What's not a lot? I don't, I think, let me see. Four is not a lot. Four is not a lot.
Okay.
These days.
Yeah.
So you're saying.
I haven't been with a lot of people. I've been with probably like maybe, if you're talking about like, you know, high school and
we're talking about your entire life, all of that counts,
right? So I haven't, okay, so from like what, 10th, 11th, 12th grade?
Well, I don't know.
I haven't slept with any of those people. I was with a guy for a year and never slept with him.
Good for you.
So you're saying your body count's only been four?
I would say four. Yeah.
Okay.
I've been with a guy for a whole year and didn't sleep with him at all. I wasn't sexually attracted to him.
Oh my god, he hung around with you? Oh boy.
What happened?
What did you guys do? Watch TV together? What did you guys do? For a whole year?
Well, it's not recent. So, you know, back in them days you were just going outside, having fun, smoking weed, drinking, chilling. You know, drinking it wasn't really It wasn't really nothing like, oh, I want to have... I wasn't into that when I was younger.
So you wasn't his girl? Like, what was you? You were just what? His
we were...
Chill buddy?
If you're talking to somebody and you're spending time with them, I mean, it's kind of like a relationship. It was just no sexual part to it. Like, you know, he used to give me money, buy me stuff, introduce him to my family, did all of that stuff. But I wasn't sleeping.
That's in the same bed?
Huh?
Well, no.
Y'all make out? Like, I don't know, man. That sounds crazy. I never heard that before. In those times,
we wasn't doing stuff like that. We wasn't thinking about stuff like that. I don't know. He was. You know what it is? Maybe because I was shy. Back in the days, I was shy. So I wasn't doing any of that stuff.
Well, I mean, it makes sense to me. It may not make sense to them, but what happened is he got friended. And yeah. So when men get stuck in the friend zone, the woman just loses attraction. And that's all it was.
Yeah.
Yeah. When you first meet a woman, no, I don't want to give these guys no game. Yeah, but it makes sense to me, man.
Well, I know the game. You can't
it's a holiday.
But, you know, he gave me stuff, gave me money, bought me food, and, you know, stuff like little.
Yep. He got fun. He got friended. Like, you see what I'm saying, Kadar? He got thrown in the friend zone.
He was trying to do anything good.
Huh?
He was trying. He was buying you shit. He was trying.
Empress, you must have a real effect on these guys because you brought JD out of the woodworks. I never heard JD talk this. JD went to chocolate, man. Never heard him talk like this, Kadar.
God.
Do you see my cute little irresistible smile?
Yeah, you can't see. You can't see. She's open.
That's carnal. Dudes that follow stuff like that get caught up into the carnal, and it never ends well for them.
Yeah, definitely.
Gotta be able to look past that, man.
That's the fact.
So tell us, Todd Doc, what was that? What was that little tip that you wanted to? You were about to let it slip. Tell us some secrets.
Nope, I'm good on it. I'm good on it. Man. But I definitely understand how, you know, she was with him for a year and nothing happened. I've seen that happen too many times.
Yep, a whole year.
Wow, good for you.
Yeah, string him along. Why not?
No, I wasn't stringing him along. I was I was just being myself.
Kador, Robin was talking like a soldier until Empress came on, man. She got an effect on the whole core. Huh?
Yeah. She knows the truth.
I've seen that play out before. It's when the women come on and they speak. And for some reason, a woman could be standing strong on the truth and this, that, and the third. But when that other woman come in speaking, they tap into them emotions and they disagree with each other. Yep. Never fails.
It's the same thing that happened to Michelle Penny. Remember?
Facts.
She started the way, man. First, she was agreeing to everything we said until the female came on her, and then she just turned cold. Oh,
man. Come.
Mm-hmm. Come. You know, I've been through similar situations like that, but when it comes right down to it, the things that I've been through, I mean, I don't
know. Emotion.
I mean, taking the alimony away, and you have to give all your money away, and you can't see anything.
Here we go, Robin Clivers.
Yep.
Wow. And it's just... It's just ridiculous. They're trying to get rid of men in society. They already did it a long time ago, but now they want a full
experience. So like, I got some more questions for you, Empress.
What is
your ideal man? What does he look like? What is a man? And I ask Robin this too. What is your ideal man look like? What is the man? Does he have to be a certain height? Does he need to make a certain amount?
No, he has to be strong.
What is that? That's too vague.
He has to be mentally strong. Mentally strong, not
Hold on, Robert. I got to probe again because you're not being honest again. So I got to probe with you. I understand your personality already. So I got to probe. Just being strong is not good enough. Okay, let's say he's strong, but he weighs 370 pounds and he's 5'2". How's that for being strong?
He has to be mentally strong.
He's 5'2 and he's 370. Uh-huh. And he's mentally strong. How's that work
out for
you?
Can't be fat.
Mentally
you have to be
strong.
Hold on.
Listen. Let him speak for himself.
He has to know how to cook.
170
pounds. Here we come. Okay.
You have to know how to cook because you got to eat, right?
Okay, why does he need to know how to cook?
Because I know how to cook.
Okay, but why does he need to know how to cook?
Because it's like an exchange, an even exchange. If I'm cooking a meal for him, he should be able to cook a meal for me.
Here we go.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
Beginning somewhere.
Yeah,
this is how you probe, Bob.
Smart for yourself.
Now you're beginning to see where a lot of these issues are coming from.
He has somewhere now. Yep.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, I can.
Let me tell you something. let me let you in on a secret, Empress. If you want a man of status, mm-hmm. and you think this man's going to be cooking for you, you're mm-hmm. going to be waiting online for the perfect man for the rest of your life. Because a man of status is going to be on his purpose. You don't have time. That's his reason for wanting a woman into his life, for being able to do those things that he doesn't really have time to do.
No, I don't. Oh. I don't knock that. If a man is busy and, like you said, if he's as status, then I'm not expecting him to have on an apron and cooking and cleaning. No, I'm not expecting.
Well, you know what? A lot of women don't get men of high status. Mm-hmm. They don't have a lot of time. They're always busy. They're always working. So the time that he's trying to spend with her, mm-hmm. you know, he values that time because he's always purpose. He's always trying to make things better. Because in his mind, everything falls on him.
Yeah, like, but he also has
the responsibility of the family falls on him.
Yes. But he also has to cater to his woman too, just like she's going to cater to him. There's nothing wrong with whipping up something or ordering something. They got Uber Eats.
Yeah. Cater. With that. But woman's word.
So, and this is what, this is the part she's missing, Kadar. A man of status is going to have so many options that, and you believe that this man is going to cater like that. It's not going to happen. He just has too many options.
So then he doesn't need to.
Here's the thing. Here's the thing, Empress. Mm-hmm. A woman that's attractive with a nice smile, a nice body, comes a dime a dozen. I could go to any city on any given day of the week and find that kind of woman. But to go and find a man of status that's making a certain amount, that's intelligent, that's not into like drugs, alcohol, hanging out at the clubs, that is a difficult thing to find in this society. It doesn't come a dime a dozen. An attractive woman comes a dime a dozen.
Definitely.
And guess what? When you find that man, a lot of other women want that same kind of man. Mm-hmm. And so that's what makes him a rarity.
So what are you saying? That he doesn't need to cater to his woman?
I'm saying he's not going to have time to do that. I'm not.
Well, he got
to
make time.
So, see, that's a romance novel.
He got to make time.
In real life, that's not going to happen. That's not going to happen, dear. In real life, he's always busy. I'm telling you. Most of these men, you're going to find out they'll. You know why you think they're making the kind of money that they're making? Because all of their time is going into that. See, that's where you're going to have to make a discernment, right? Mm-hmm. So it sounds like you want regular man qualities with a man of status, post, and so on and so forth. You see what I'm saying? Because a regular man, he has time to do that. Mm-hmm. He could spend all that time with you and be booed up and all of that. You want a benign, and not a Kevin Samuels or someone. You see what I'm saying? Benaiah is going to have time to do that.
He can be.
He's going to make time, man. And he'll come over with a bunch of baby bibs all weekend.
He can be busy, but he still got to find time. If you're that busy, if you're too busy to be with a woman and to cater to her, then you don't need to be with that woman. Just go around and, you know, you shouldn't be in nothing serious. Because a woman wants things.
A man of status doesn't have to change your woman.
Go ahead. What was that, Ren?
I said that a man of status doesn't have to cater to one woman. He has.
Yep. He's not going to.
That can.
No, he don't have to cater to one. I'm just saying the woman has needs also. The woman has needs. So what are you doing to keep that woman around? If you don't want her around, then. You know,
let me explain something to you, Empress. When you meet a guy like that, that man is usually straight up, this is what I do, this is what I have time for. Right. If you want to be a part of this, fine. Right. If not, shalom,
nothing
have a nice that. Day.
Nothing
That's
wrong.
How he works.
Right.
Because that, so in order to sustain that standard of living, is really toxic. You know, it's really tantalizing on him. And so, you know, you got to appreciate what he has to, and just about every man of status is like that. They see these men that's like really filthy rich, but they don't realize how much time is going into, like, retaining that kind of lifestyle. It's not easy.
You're right. They need to have that communication in the beginning.
She thinks she got it like that too. That she thinks she has a good she has a career in that whole thing, you know. So she's
no. What I'm saying is,
he doesn't care about that.
A man of status, right?
He doesn't care about her career.
Right, he doesn't care.
He don't care about that. He don't care about her money.
Communication needs to be had in the beginning, so the woman knows. Okay, this is what he wants. This is what he's expecting. Okay. Then, like you said, she makes the choice. But if you're not communicating that to her, like, listen, honey, I'm busy. You know, I can make time for you when I can, blah, blah, blah. They need to have that communication in the beginning. Because a woman, if she likes you and she wants to be around you, she's going to be okay with whatever.
He's going to put her to work.
Huh?
He's going to put her to work for him. That's usually what he's going to do. He's going to put her to work for him.
Yep.
Okay. If she get bored, keep her busy.
Is she making money?
You don't have to.
Okay. So how is he keeping her busy?
He's putting
her to work for him.
Work for him?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right. Is he?
Instead
is
of her
she
going paid? Out? Instead of her going out, working in society, if she wants to be with him, more time with him, she's going to be working in the home somehow.
Run the home, exactly.
Unless she, yep. Or, you know, if he got a job or whatever that requires secretarial, or if she's gifted at, like, let's say, editing or what have you, whatever talent, or utilize those talents.
Yep.
And they're building the empire together. That's the whole purpose.
That would be great.
Amen.
That would be great, but it's not like that. It's hardly like that. You know, I think, well, I'm going to speak for myself. That's what I'm looking for. You know, like a team.
No, but why is it hard to work for him? You're saying it's hard to
work for him? What are you looking for? You thought you were married.
No, it's not hard to work for him.
Good, JD. You heard what JD said?
What he said.
Hey, Kadar, you heard what JD say? JD's probing, man.
Yeah.
He's probing, probing.
Well, I mean, you just said you were married, right?
I am.
What are you looking for?
I'm not looking for anything.
JD, we're about to call Stefan back. Oh, Kadar, I fell out, man. We're about to call Stefan back up for you.
I'm still waiting for him to pop up.
Yes.
Come on. What do you Rasta man?
Hey, and Empress, I'm detecting some sort of like maybe Saint Lucia or some sort of accent from you.
Me, I'm from Jamaica.
Oh yeah, I thought so. I hear something. I thought I heard something. I used to live.